In this video, I'll walk you through a clear step-by-step example of how to properly implement nested horizontal scroll views, ensuring smooth interactions, responsive layouts, and a seamless user experience. Nesting horizontal scroll views in SwiftUI can be a real pain due to challenges with layout conflicts, gesture handling, and maintainability. Smooth scrolling performance, not to say the least. SwiftUI's default behavior often leads to unexpected results, making it frustrating to align and synchronize multiple scrollable areas. Now, let's dive in. Today, we are going to dive deep into nested scroll views. Scroll view within a scroll view within a scroll view. This is what we are going to learn about today. And if you do like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out the link in the description where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. It's called rebeloper.com/mentoring. Meet with an iOS developer if you have bugs in your code, or if you want to learn SwiftUI, go ahead and check out, the link is down in the description. So today we are going to talk about scroll views, how to implement scroll views, and how to add scroll view within a scroll view, most particularly. So what are we trying to achieve over here? Well, I'm going to add a paging mechanism. So we have paging, not with the tab view. We are going to use scroll views for that. And then I'm going to have on each of these pages, I'm going to have a scroll view that is vertically scrolling, and at the bottom, another scroll which is horizontally scrolling. And inside of each of these scroll views, I'm going to have these cells with colors and the colors of the names of those colors. Now, the issue here will be, and you will see shortly, with the bottom horizontal scroll view, because I want this to be bouncing when it gets to the end. But as you will see, because we are inside the, so we are inside the horizontal scroll view with a vertical scroll view, and again, a horizontal scroll view, it's just going to behave oddly. It's going to go for the next page if we swipe, which we don't want to. Let's just type out the code and you will see how awesome it is to leverage the power of scroll views in SwiftUI. So let's start off with the obvious one. Let's create a cell. So I'm going to create a new file from template. A SwiftUI view will be just fine. And let's call this cell. Okay. And inside the cell, I'm going to need a color. So let color of type color, there we go. And right over here, I'm going to also create the custom initializer, why not? So we can omit always adding that property name. You know, now it's an inner property and the outer property is an underscore, so we don't have to type out color equals and whatever. I'm just going to say self.red. Okay, self.color equals color, that's right. Let's remove the preview so it does not bother us. And then let's create this cell. So I'm going to set up a color of clear, so you can just replace this with anything that you want and give it a background and an overlay. So color dot clear, and I'm going to set a background, and this will be a background with a content. So the content will be our rounded rectangle with a corner radius of 15, and then let's fill this with the color, and let's have also a padding of 6. And then I also want to add in the names of those colors, so let's have that as an overlay, okay, with a text. And then not cell, but rather I would just have the colors dot description. There we go, color dot description. This is our cell. We're going to reuse it in many places. Next up, let's create our page. So for the page, let's create a new file again. It will still be a SwiftUI view. So let's call this page. There we go. And inside the page, I'm going to need some colors, you know, an array of colors that can be populated into these cells. So let's have that first. So let colors, that's an array of colors. Let's remove the preview so it would not complain about it. And also, you will see in just a second, we also need the geometry proxy. So we are going to size the actual cells. So let's have that also, geometry. It's a geometry proxy. Okay, let's create a custom initializer because I would like to have that. And let's have underscore for the colors. Really nice. We have all that we need. Now it's time to build the body for it. Having a SwiftUI mentor can dramatically elevate your developer status by providing personalized guidance, tailored solutions to challenges, and insider insights that fast-track your growth. As your mentor, I'll help you unlock the full potential of SwiftUI from mastering advanced concepts to refining your coding practices. My mentoring sessions are designed to empower you to build professional-grade iOS apps confidently, gain a deeper understanding of SwiftUI's ecosystem, and stand out in the competitive developer landscape. Don't just learn SwiftUI, master it with my expert mentorship. Click the link in the description to find out. I'm going to create a lazy V stack, with a spacing of zero, because I'm going to add in here two things, two scroll views, one vertical, you know, we are talking about the page, a vertical scroll view, and at the bottom, a horizontal scroll view. And remember, this page will be also added into a horizontal scroll view, but we are going to get there. Just take a look at the video till the end. So first of all, let's add that vertical one. So scroll view, and let's specifically say that it is a vertical one, so know what we are talking about right over here. By the way, you could just omit this if you choose to, but you know, it reads a lot better, the code reads a lot better. Because this is a vertical scroll view, I am going to add this inside a lazy V stack, again with a spacing of zero, and then we have this for each. With the colors, I'm going to go for the indices because it's much easier for me. But, you know, now it's time to add in the for each. That's fine, for each. And then I'm going to go zero and all the way up to the colors dot count. And then the ID will be self, you know, the indices. Come on. There we go. And then right over here, we are going to get back an index in. Okay, now it's time to use the cell that we have created to populate our for each. So cell, and then we are going to have color. And right over here, we are going to grab the colors index, so colors. And then I could just go for the index for now, but I'm going to do that at the bottom, you know, the horizontal one. I'm going to revert the array of those colors. So for that, I'm going to say colors.count, colors.count, and minus index minus one. Yeah, that's right, because we are starting the index with zero. Okay, so we have the cell, and now what I want to do is make sure that it's of certain height and width. Now, this is the vertical scroll view. I want this to be of the full width of our screen. Let's just have this frame. It added quite a lot of useless code. So let's have frame, and width will be width and height. Yes, the width will be coming from the geometry, geometry.size.width, so the whole width, there we go. And then the height, let's just have an arbitrary number right over here, 300. Alignment, center will be just fine. So this is our vertical scroll view. Yeah, makes sense. It's as easy as that. Now let's add a little bit more extra. Let's add our horizontal scroll view. So right over here, after the vertical scroll view, I'm going to create before I do that, I want to make sure these are scroll views and all of that. I want to make sure that the vertical one is of certain height. So let's create a frame, and the height will be the geometry.size.height and minus 100, because I want the horizontal one at the bottom to be 100. Okay, you could just add all of this to the horizontal one, but I prefer, you know, just using it on the vertical one is perfectly fine. Okay, finally, we want to add our scroll view that is going to be horizontal. So I just have this dot horizontal. And right over here, again, in this case, lazy horizontal stack. with a spacing, again, spacing of 0. And here we have our for each. Now, it will be a little bit different. So for each, we are going to again go through the indices. So dot, dot, colors, dot, count. And then ID equals self. And here we are going to get back an index. Yeah. But in this case, I'm just going to use the cell and then colors at that index. So, yeah, a little bit of, you know, it's not the same array, basically, just reverted. And then I want to give a certain frame to this cell too. Remember, the height should be actually 100. Let me just add this in here. The height should be 100, so 100, there we go. And then the width, we should just set this to some arbitrary number, 160. I think that looks really nice. Okay, so we got our page. We have a vertical scroll view. We have a horizontal scroll view. Now let's add this into the content view as those pages would scroll horizontally. Okay, so now, we should create that geometry reader first. So geometry reader with a content, and we're going to have in here a geometry, and then let's have a scroll view that will be horizontal, and then the content. Again, lazy horizontal stack with a spacing of 0. I'm always setting these spacings so I don't get these extra paddings, spacings between my elements. And then for each, we are going to go through our colors array, which I did not add just yet. Let me just add our data. And I'm just simply going to copy this out from my notes over here to not waste time on that. It's basically a two-dimensional array. This is going to be the array for the first page, and then for the second page, and then for the third page. And of course, the vertical scroll inside the page will be reverted. So it will say yellow, green, and blue. And then the horizontal at the bottom will be red, blue, green, and yellow. Okay, so let's use this. So we have this for each, and then again, 0 till colors array dot count. Okay, and then the ID will be self. Yeah, I'm assuming that these arrays are unique. As you can see, they are currently, but you know, you can just go for identifiables in your case. So let's have the index in. Okay, oh, sorry, I'm using the indices, so they don't have to be unique. Yeah, forgot about that. Okay, so now I'm going to use the page and page, open parentheses. And you see, we need a colors array and the geometry. So the colors array, we are going to fetch it from the colors array at that particular index. And then geometry, we just pass it along. And it's as simple as that. Now, next, we want this scroll view to be paging. And that's, again, one line of code. On the scroll view itself, just add scroll, scroll target behavior, and you want to select paging. There we go. Okay, so we built out our app. We have cells, and then we have a page which has vertical scrolling with those cells, and then horizontal scrolling with those cells, and all of these pages are within a horizontal scroll view. Hopefully that you already can imagine this. What I'm going to do is just launch this on my actual phone, because we are going to do some heavy testing. We are going to swipe quite a lot over here, and you will see what the actual problems are. So let me just switch to my phone over here so we can see it better. And let's see how all of this looks like. There we go. It's launching. So as you can see, we have the yellow, green, and blue. Let me just move our data over here, and then again our quick time. So we have yellow, green, blue, red. So again, that red, blue, and green. Let's try start swiping. There we go, on the horizontal, vertical one. Really nice. Now, on the actual horizontal one at the bottom, and you can already see there are some issues right over here when I'm swiping right over here at the bottom. So if I swipe at the top, it's obvious, it should page like this. That's right. Three pages, really nice. And this one is a bit longer. This one is really long, all the way down to the purple. But if I want to swipe at the bottom, we have some issues right over here. Let me just tell you what happens. If I swipe all the way to the back, the yellow appears right over here. And if I start swiping again at the bottom, it will just swipe to the next page, which is not what I want. This is not as intended. It should be different. It should be like bouncing like it is when I first try to bounce, like we did right over here with the red. So in order to fix this, it's really, really a tricky one. I've been working for this for a client and it took me days to figure this out, but it's really, really simple and I wanted to share this with you. So what you want to do is go back to that, you know, the bottom horizontal scroll view. It's inside the page, this one, scroll view with a horizontal. What you want to do actually is nest this horizontal scroll view. Remember, this is inside a page which is inside the horizontal. So a scroll view, we are having a horizontal scroll view within a horizontal scroll view. So SwiftUI doesn't really understand what's going on. It does understand when you are at the end of this horizontal scroll view, it says, okay, now I need to swipe the other horizontal scroll view, the outer one. So what you need to do is actually wrap this into a vertical scroll view. So let's just add all of this right over here. And that's the only thing you have to do. So this horizontal scroll view inside the vertical scroll view. So now we have the outer horizontal scroll view, then a vertical one, and then this horizontal one, which we had issues with. So now let's build it one once more. And let's see how this looks like currently. So now that bouncing issue is going to be fixed. So first of all, let's test that this is paging correctly. Yeah, it does. And you know, we can just scroll up and down. Now, if I just swipe over here, you see, it's not actually grabbing the whole page like this one. I'm trying, you know, I was swiping over here and then at the bottom right over here. So yeah, now it's behaved as expected. Let's see if I swipe all the way to the yellow. And I'm trying. And you see, it's not doing this type of animation. It's just doing this type of bouncing, which is really what we actually needed. Now, this is a really, really tricky thing to do. I just worked on this for hours, as I told you. Hope you enjoyed this. If you did, go ahead and check out also my mentoring sessions. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. The link is down in the description if you want to meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call.